Hi everyone, discussing another important image question, and topic for today's image question is Moro's reflex. Now you know that this Moro's reflex is very important while you are doing the neurological examination of a neonate. Now what is this Moro's reflex and what is its clinical importance, we will be discussing in this video. Now see here. What is this Moro's reflex? It is actually the abduction and extension followed by adduction and flexion of the upper limbs. Now how it is performed is, you know that during your posting you have seen that some of your residents may be performing this Moro's reflex. You have to take the child in hands and at 45 degree angle you have to take the child and suddenly you jerk the child downwards, so this reflex is elicited and the response is abduction and extension followed by adduction and flexion of the upper limbs. So this is a complete Moro's reflex, or it is also known as symmetrical Moro's reflex. So this is a complete Moro's reflex. Now moving on, I have told you Moro's reflex is a neonatal reflex or primitive reflex. Why primitive? Because as the life progresses, as the baby grows, this reflex disappears. So it is a primitive reflex, and you know that this reflex once disappeared never reappears in the course of life. Now what are the components of Moro's reflex? As I told you, abduction and extension followed by adduction and flexion. Now onset, it usually starts at 28 to 32 weeks of gestation and fully developed at 37 weeks of gestation. Now you know that what is the significance of this. If baby is premature, if baby is delivered before the delivery date or before the term gestation, this reflex will not be elicited. This reflex either be not be elicited properly or not fully developed. Now when this reflex disappears, this reflex disappears 6 to 7 months of life after postnatal. So what is the significance of disappearance of the Moro's reflex? Disappearance of the Moro's reflex signifies that the brain of the baby is mature. You have to remember that disappearance of the Moro's reflex signifies that brain of the baby is mature. Now you have to remember that all these neonatal reflexes have some of the significance. Once they appear or once they disappear, there is a development of certain type of behavioral change or certain type of event which take place in the baby's developmental chart. So this Moro's reflex disappearance suggests that brain of the baby is mature. So remember this. Important points regarding this Moro's reflex is that absent Moro's reflex, it is seen in the anencephaly. You know that anencephaly is a condition in which brain is absent. It is associated with folate deficiency or folic acid deficiency. Second is HIE. HIE is hypoxic ischemic encephalopathy. It is usually seen in stage 3 and Down syndrome. Another is acute bilirubin encephalopathy. Now you have to remember all of these because there is a clinical correlated question which are currently asked in the exam, and they can give you any of this scenario and they can frame the question on Moro's reflex. Now unilateral or asymmetric Moro's reflex. This reflex is seen when there are two scenarios in the baby, that is nerve injury or bone injury. So nerve injury is brachial plexus injury. Most commonly it is the Erb's palsy and the root involved are C5 and C6. Bone injury, you know that most common bone injured is clavicle, which related with the absent Moro's reflex or unilateral Moro's reflex. Now this clavicle fracture is most common during neonate period, and it is associated with the shoulder dystocia. Shoulder dystocia is a condition which is seen in the macrosomic babies or infant of a diabetic mother, in which there is a difficulty in the delivery of a shoulder, or you can say that there is an impaction of the shoulder during the labor. Again, moving on, there is another condition which is persistent Moro's reflex. Now, persistent Moro's reflex, you know that for more than 6 months. If Moro's reflex is persisting for more than 6 months, it is associated with cerebral palsy. Remember this condition, cerebral palsy. If this Moro's reflex is persisting for the 6 months, you know that it signifies immature brain. Why brain is immature? Because there is some kind of injury which happened due to the condition known as cerebral palsy. Now, what is the clinical correlation which we can get in the exam, or how the question will be framed? So most common scenario they will give you like this, that a macrosomic baby or infant of a diabetic mother, on examination there was a unilateral Moro's reflex, and they will give you this is associated with a nerve injury or bone injury. They can give you a in options brachial plexus palsy, or they can give you that clavicle fracture. So you have to remember this. Now I am moving on to another important image which is given in your book, that is OP Guy textbook. In this, you have to see here this image. You have to see this image here. Try to see here. This is a unilateral Moro's reflex. This is unilateral Moro's reflex. Try to remember this condition. I have told you that this is seen in nerve injury or bone injury. Try to remember this image, because this image can be given in your examination. Rest of the images, you know that they are eliciting symmetrical Moro's reflex. Now I am ending this video on the note that this Moro's reflex, what is this, the significance of this Moro's reflex, why we are studying? Because this Moro's reflex signifies the maturity of the brain. If any condition is there in which there is a damage to the brain, either there will be an absent Moro reflex or there will be a persistent Moro's reflex. You remember this. I have told you all the condition in which there is either absent Moro's reflex or there is a persistent Moro's reflex. Why Moro's reflex is absent? Because brain has not reached that maturity level. And why Moro's reflex is persisting? Because the brain is not achieving the required maturity because of some pathology. So thanks for watching. Thank you, and do like, share and subscribe my channel.